I'm Heather Stapleton. I'm a professor of exposure science and environmental health at the Nicholas School of the Environment.
So I'm Richard DiGiulio, professor of environmental toxicology in the Nicholas School of the Environment. I was the founding director of the Superfund Research Center in the year 2000.
The Duke University Superfund Research Center is actually one of several Superfund research centers across the country, which are supported by the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences. So the Superfund Research Program in general, the umbrella, seeks to support research that helps to develop new technologies, new methods or approaches for detecting hazardous chemicals in the environment, or for new approaches for assessing the risks that hazardous chemicals may pose to human health.
Ever since 2000, the general theme has been impacts on development. We started off looking more directly at early life development, and now more recently we've kind of morphed into this later life consequences of early life exposures, and then going into the future, we're still expanding that.
Our group has done a lot of research focusing on consumer product testing. In particular, our group has focused on identifying and characterizing flame retardant chemical applications in consumer products, such as furniture, electronics, and other items. And it's actually very unique. It's the only service of its kind, which provides information directly to the general public and allows them to test products in their home so that they can make more informed decisions about the products they bring into their home.
We did some really pioneering work on lead exposures in Durham and environmental justice issues associated with those exposures.
The funding that our Superfund Research Center receives in particular has just been monumental, fundamental in helping to support research, but also trainees in a number of ways.
A key thing has been how it's promoted interdisciplinary work among the four major schools at Duke that have been involved. And it has had a key role in fomenting this true interdisciplinary nature. And that's really how the Superfund started.